When a patient suffers a large burn, their body goes into shock. The old term for that is burn shock. If you consider a patient who has lost a significant amount of blood, say from an auto accident or from a gunshot wound or a knife wound, that patient is suffering from shock. With a burn wound, it's similar. While the patient does not go into shock from the loss of whole blood, they do go into shock from the loss of the fluid component of blood. If you burn yourself by touching a hot iron or a hot pot, you might get a blister. And that is an illustration of how the body reacts to a burn wound. There's a loss of fluid. And if you consider that small blister that you might have on the back of your hand, but think about now a large burn covering 30, 40, or 50% of the patient's body, now you can start to understand why the patient goes into shock from that loss of fluid. Our treatment for that is to administer intravenous fluids so that we can very rapidly and very aggressively replace the fluid that's being lost through the burn wound so that we can maintain the patient's blood pressure. And by maintaining the blood pressure, we are maintaining the circulation to the vital organs, particularly the brain. And through that resuscitation, it's what we call that, resuscitation, hopefully then we can get the patient through that period of shock. What we are doing at the Western Medical Center is resuscitating large burns using a blood product known as fresh frozen plasma. In using fresh frozen plasma, we are able to treat the patient for burn shock while at the same time actually giving less fluid than traditional resuscitation formulas would call for. That increases the likelihood of an early resuscitation, but also decreases the chance of some of the other complications we see. But we have to first get the patient through that period of shock successfully.